name is Tim Becker. I'm from Aneuvas Technologies, and we're working on a new device for treating aneurysms called NeuroCURE, and it's a gel-based material, does not use any forms of metal, and it can be delivered inside of an aneurysm to completely fill it and completely heal the vessel so that the aneurysm will not grow in the future. This can be a pretty big jump in the technology, and people are just kind of jaw-dropper, like, wow, that's really exciting. I have an aunt that had an aneurysm and passed away about 20 years ago. I also have a kind of a distant cousin that had an AVM, which is another kind of vessel malformation in the brain that never made it past 8 years old. Aneurysm is kind of a ballooning of the side of the blood vessel. So you have the flow going through the vessel, and then the aneurysm can grow off to the side, kind of like a balloon getting filled up. It'll weaken and then it can burst. And then you're basically, there's blood going onto the brain instead of, you know, feeding the brain for nutrients. So very serious condition when that occurs. The most traditional way of treating aneurysm would be to have brain surgery to access the aneurysm and clip it off so that it doesn't burst. You know, this is obviously a very invasive procedure. Over the last 15, 20 years, we've really tried to come up with devices that you can treat from inside the blood vessel. You can place a small catheter from the leg, you can access anywhere in the brain and treat the vessel from inside. Types of devices over the last 15 years or so are metal-based. The gel material that we're using is more of kind of a liquid material that comes out, fills the aneurysm and solidifies. And it forms exactly to the aneurysm shape, and it's very elastic, and it will keep the aneurysm from growing. Versus the coiling, you have the tiny catheter and these little metal coils that kind of pop out, and they kind of push them up one at a time into the aneurysm and fill it. And then you have kind of these little metal coils kind of where the blood flow is, and that's been a bit of an issue. The tissue doesn't want to grow on that very well, so it's hard to sustain it. Whereas if you have a gel and you have a little support right there, it'll form to that and you'll have a nice smooth surface for the tissue to regrow and the blood flow to continue on without causing a stroke. And metal coils, since they have a preset shape, they can't completely fill the space. So there's a lot of empty space, which means blood clot and blood flow. And that's really what kind of makes aneurysm grow over time. But with the gel materials, you can completely fill that space. You're removing any kind of risks of it regrowing. It can be done very fast. It takes about 3 minutes, whereas a lot of these procedures take up to an hour or more. And the other important thing, too, is since the gel material is very compatible with the body, they don't have to use a lot of the dual antiplatelet drugs that are trying to keep your blood thin, because they're worried about blood clots forming. It kind of opens a new area where it's difficult to treat a ruptured aneurysm now, because the patient has a very high risk of continuing to bleed, whereas this material will allow to seal that off and give a long-term solution. Brain Aneurysm Foundation helped Aneuvas Technologies advance a kind of a preliminary idea for a new device, so that we could actually build it and test it. From that, we were able to get some really excellent preliminary data that allowed us to get a much bigger grant from the National Institute of Health. The fact that the Brain Aneurysm Foundation has helped, you know, companies and myself and engineers come up with new devices is a really kind of exciting and key component to advancing this area. So no one person has the answer. We need to create these great groups of people that are working on it from different facets. The Brain Aneurysm Foundation really helped us see the bigger picture as well, and the patients that we could help and the surgeons that we could work with. We may have approval for this new device within about a year, maybe 2 years from now. The funding from Brain Aneurysm Foundation really accelerated that timeline. Without that, it probably would have been maybe 3 to 4, maybe 5 years, or maybe not at all. Things that affect the brain are, you know, it's scary. It's probably the scariest thing that a patient will ever have to deal with, you know, and if we can come up with great ways to treat these and get rid of that fear and give them a lot of hope, that's what drives me, and I think that's what drives a lot of my students and my researchers. You're completely saving lives, and you're making sure that patient lives a normal life. And that's the hope with our devices.